Hello and welcome. So in today's video we are going to install Waza. It's a sim. I'm gonna install it on one of my virtual machines like this one. This one is the CentOS and Ubuntu. I'm gonna install this on my Ubuntu machine as the server side. I'm gonna call one server and the other one is the agent. Even though you can see every sim has indexer, server and a dashboard. I'm gonna install all these three components on my Ubuntu. And I'm gonna install the agent on this CentOS. For today's video, I'm gonna follow this guide, this documentation. If you, this is just for educational purposes. If somebody wants to see how to install agents without going through all this, you can come and read this. There are YAML, APT, YAML obviously for CentOS and APT for the Debian based. I am going to install this on the Ubuntu. Let's get started. So first thing first, I'm going to check quickly one thing on the terminal. F20 right there. So let's go to CentOS, do the same thing. That is interesting, but this is what we're looking for. ENPOS3 is basically your Ethernet. Most of the time when you're using VirtualBox, that's what you look for, and you can see ENPOS3. You can see 10.0.2.15. It's a good thing I got it now. 10.0.2.15. So what's happening is NAT is in play, network address translation. So basically, and these two virtual machines on my desktop, when they're going through the they're going to get anything on the internet, VirtualBox itself is dealing them or considering them as one machine and using NAT to get them their internet connectivity. We're gonna change that. I'm running this, so Ubuntu. I'm gonna go to network. See, it was NAT, so I'm gonna make it a bridge. Now it's gonna bridge to my physical. Same thing, let's do it with the NAT. Okay, yep. So let's make it bridge. So bridged basically means is that it's gonna bridge to my host physical network, the physical network card on my host, and it's gonna get its own IP address. They should. Let's try this command one more time, and I have a new IP address right there. You can see in POS3. Let's try it, and hopefully right there. Now the reason this is important is when you are deploying the agents, you need to tell them what the server IP address is. So that will be, since I want to install it on my Ubuntu, this will become the server IP address. If they were the same, then both machines have the same IP address, so they will thinking that they are both the agent and the server. So we got that thing out of the way. Let's go to our installation guide. And it says download the Waza installation. That is, now this is important right here. This is version 4.7. This officially does not support Splunk, meaning the capability is not in there. You have to go and make an add-on. If you're looking for maybe a month ago I was doing Splunk. If you're doing the same thing, go for 4.5. Use the same command, just make it 4.5. So you'll have Splunk in there and you can play with it. If you follow this one, 4.7, you'll have to do the add-on stuff and you have to search. Luckily, I'm not doing it. So I'm just gonna go here and paste it. I have my in there, hit enter. And I have a problem. The coolest thing about Ubuntu is most of the time when I'm running a command and it's not in there, it tells me how to get it right there. So whichever you want to go, I'm going to go with the first one. So let's type it in, sudo snap install crew. Now if I were to go and do this, this should get me my file. Now this one is getting the file and it's put it on my local machine. If you don't have any error, it goes to the next prompt. In Linux it means it was successful. Now what we can do is run this command. Basically what it's doing is we just downloaded this command. If you can see here, we just got this command through curl, we downloaded it. Now it's instructing our system to run this script through bash. That's what we're gonna do. You can see, if you want to see the logging information, it's in here, .log. This does take a little bit of time. You can see, cannot find home imran.tar. Run the script with the open option. Generate config files created or copied from another source. Installing curl, cannot find home. Let's do something. ls 744 waza tab. Let's try to run one more time. Nope, okay. Let's try it. G generate config files. Let's try dash A. Uninstall with a switch A. For all. Now we're progressing. It says 443. In the documentation, I did see somewhere being mentioned 443. By the way, I have installed it on my home network. So what I have done is I have installed it on a virtual machine, and agents are on physical machines as well as on virtual machines. It's been a couple of days, and it's gathering data. At this point I'm more interested in when it shows hey, these are the vulnerabilities we found. Especially I was looking for that if you've seen recently, there was a BitLocker exploit. So I was looking for when it catches it. I have a couple of Windows 10 virtual machines, so I'm sure they should be in there. So you can see now it's gonna do the indexer installation. Make sure that you're using this A. I think I was just supposed to use dash G and not the generate config files, but it is what it is. pause the video because I think it's just like it's gonna take its time. So this is what I normally do, and to check where the bottleneck is. It seems it's downloading. Like CPU is normal, that's pretty much normal, but 8 megabits per second on my Ethernet, that's where what's happening in the background. It's getting its files and downloading them. So I'm gonna pause the video again. Alright, so you can see it took good 15 minutes or maybe more. In the meantime, this happened, so I checked with the top. Yes, it was APT was in the top few going up and down, and it was running by the Vaza, so I did not kill it. I just waited for it to finish while it was retrying, and you can see now it's starting the file beat. Oh, file beat is finished. Dashboard is being installed. I'm gonna pause the video here again, but it should be pretty quick now. So all in all, I will say from start to finish, probably it was 20, 25, 30 minutes installation. I'm gonna pause and let's see. All right, so I have my installation complete. What you can see is once it's done, so all in all, it was close to 30 minutes installation. I started around 11:30. Now it's 11:58. I am pretty sure it was due to, let's see, Ubuntu 4 cores. Okay, now I thought maybe it was due to the fact that it did not have enough processing power, but no, it does take 30 minutes then. 4, I gave it once CPU. The other one I gave it two CPU and 4 cores each. Anyways, it's done. You can see summary over here. You can see the web interface. Now, since this is installed on this machine, so this dashboard IP is this machine's IP address. Now here, keep a note, you have the password here, make sure that you copy it. If you don't have this or you lose it, you were to close this window, you cannot log in. I'm gonna copy it and paste it on my clipboard. Can we do this echo? So I wasn't sure, I just wanted to try it offline and before doing it on camera, but oh, I just forgot to remove this 200. But I have cap pwd.txt, it's there. Nano pwd.txt. Control O X. Beautiful. Now let's find the IP address. Remember the IP address? That is this. Now open the web browser. Or actually you can go to CentOS and you can log in from there. See, so if you were to open a Firefox window here, you can go to 10.17.17.111, I believe, advanced, and you can see accept risk and continue, and you can see it's right there. Do I have my clipboard here? Apparently I do. But we do know that it's not the right password. I'll have to go over there and copy it again on Ubuntu. Where are you, Ubuntu? 10.17.17.1 here. Copy. I just want to try it on CentOS. see I logged in. I'm gonna save it here. The reason, so I can, no, actually I can cross copy paste through my clipboard, but on Proxmox you can't. It's a pain. So you can see here, no agents are added. I can add an agent here. For the agent, what I'm gonna do is, actually this video is let's create the agent quickly then. Now we know that this CentOS is gonna use RPM. We know it's AMD, it's not Arch, ARM. We know the IP address of this, the server is 10.sys17.17.111. The agent name we're gonna do is CentOS7. Go with default, and this is the copy command. We copy it, and what is the terminal? I had terminal here, and I paste it in here. Just press enter, it will do its thing. You can see it's download and installation. I like this one on the CentOS better than the Ubuntu one. Debian based, it's asking for the password. You can see the agent is being installed, 4.7.2. The name we given in the in here, you can see this name CentOS 7 is actually this one right there, right where my cursor is, right above there. That basically tells the agent in the WAZ interface. It's for easier remembrance of that machine. Alternatively, I believe if you don't follow this and you follow this installation and you just use this command, what will happen, it will pick the machine's name, the, and that's how it will done. But I like this one because I have machines that I know which one does what, so I name them accordingly. If I were to go to here, I have the next prompt, and now I have to write these commands. We do, oh, d reload, oh, sudo, I can't see apparently. Alright, sudo system cdl enable was agent. Okay, sudo system cdl start was agent. This should be it. Give me the prompt. I have my prompt. If I were to go, this time I'm gonna go to Ubuntu. I'm just giving, buying time for it to get the data from the agent. Because if you go too quickly, what will happen is that you will just, it'll take maybe a brief second, but it will show up. And that brief second is already passed, so we should be able to see it here. I'll check. You can see total agents, active agents. So if you were to shut down a machine, this number does go down. So if we were to go and click on agents, you can see CentOS 7. So now I know, hey, which machine is that? After a while, you start getting all the logs. Most of them are logins. Like I said, I'll have to wait. The cool thing was, no modules, probably security events, something like that. So this start piling up. It has like, it has some logs, but it gets the other logs as well, like events and all that. And you can start going through, just like Splunk, you can start going through and working your way up on learning SIM. Alright, so hopefully I'm gonna wrap this video here. This was just the installation. of the SIM itself and the agent on one machine. We have done that. We do see we have logs. We can start playing with it, but that's not the scope of this video. I'm gonna wrap this video here. Hopefully this video has helped you. If it has, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share, and I see you in the next one.